Hello, everybody. So my plan was to start early this morning and just basically do a day in my life of an online student now. And so, well, I was supposed to start early this morning. I didn't wake up till like 10, and it is now 11:30, and I've been doing my homework for a little bit. So I'll just basically be explaining the things I've done already since I didn't start this morning. But so every morning, I try to wake up around 9 o'clock, but it gets harder and harder because like when I was at school, I'd wake up at 7:30 every day. I would leave my house around like 8:15, and I would go up to this place called the Trio office, and I would just sit there and conversate with the two ladies that work in there, and then I would go to class. And so now I don't wake up at 7:30. That has not happened since I've been home before spring break. And so now I just wake up, I go in my kitchen. My little sister and my mom are out there. My sister's doing her schoolwork since she is in third grade. And my mom is doing whatever she's doing. And so I try to wake up at least around 8:45, 9 o'clock every day, but that did not happen, like I said. So today I woke up around 10, I woke up, made my smoothie, ate some breakfast, and I came in here and something I really found out to help is making a to-do list. So I made my to-do list. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Around 9 things I want to get done today. And so I think making a list and like sticking to it. And so that's something I found out that has helped a lot the last 2 weeks of me being online. And something, it's a completely different thing because it's a lot more work, I would have to say. It's something that you have to stick to it, and you cannot just be like, oh, I'll do that later, because you won't do it later. You'll have something else to do later. And so that's something I found. I was making a to-do list and sticking to that to-do list, not adding anything else unless it's like very important. And so like today I have to do a math exam, a math quiz, and then a speaking exam for my Spanish class. And so I'll try to get those two done today. And so that's just really what's going on right now. I have my smoothie still, but I just ate a cough drop, so it's not gonna be nasty. It's gonna be nasty. I'm doing one of my classes, EDUC 245, Landscaping of Teaching. Gives us basically the landscaping of teaching on what we need to know. And so, yeah, but that's basically what has been going on this Monday. It is April 6th at 11:31, and actually right now it is April 7th at around 9:15 at night, and I just thought I'd really get on here real quick and explain what the last few days have looked like and what I've been doing the last couple videos. So the last few days have been really, really nice outside, and I think that has helped. Like I said, the last couple videos, that I feel that the weather, and everyone says that the weather can have a really big impact on how you feel that day, and being stuck inside is not helping it at all. Not being able to really go anywhere is really not helping it at all. And so I feel like with the nice weather, like today, it literally got up to 78 degrees outside. And so we all got to go outside and literally just sit outside all day. I did my homework, and I feel that with the sun, like I know this is like crazy, but I feel like many, many people can agree that when you have nice weather, it changes your mood drastically, because the last few days it was raining, it was gloomy, it was cold. Like one day, it literally, I want to say last Friday or last Thursday, which would have been like April 1st or 2nd, it literally got, I want to say like 20 something degrees, and it was raining, but it was so cold it started freezing, and so we couldn't go outside, we couldn't go anywhere, and like couldn't even walk around our house. And so that's something that, since we're not allowed to go anywhere, since we're not allowed to really, you only can walk. And so that's what I've been doing a lot, is just walking around, hammocking outside. And so that's something else, that's really, being outside has really, really made a big impact on how I'm getting things done. It's quiet. Living in a family with 8 people, you don't get too much quiet, you don't get too much time by yourself. And so going outside, it's just really quiet, and just sitting there, relaxing in my hammock, just chilling, not doing too much. But something that I'm gonna be able to experience, that many people around the world are experiencing right now, is having their birthday in quarantine. I turn 22 tomorrow, April 8th, and I will be able to spend it inside. So not like I had anything planned, but I'll get to, that's something that I'll, this is gonna, like my 22nd birthday is gonna be something that I'm definitely gonna remember, because it was during something drastic, and I'm like, oh, I remember that I was stuck inside. I didn't get to do anything. What was going on that day? What happened? And so that's something that I'm really, I don't want to say looking forward, but I'm like anxious. Like, I'm like, oh, this is something that I'm going to be able to like experience. Like, oh, your birthday. And like, so yeah, some people like their birthday's not a big deal, but it's like, hopefully this is a once in a lifetime experience that I get to say, I spent my 22nd birthday in quarantine and didn't get to do anything. But that's something that I thought I would just get on here and explain before tomorrow's video, because I'll just basically do a birthday in quarantine type of thing and see how everything goes. And so I'll talk a little bit about how online classes are going, but I feel like online classes, it's a lot harder than being in class. You have to be determined. You have to have a set schedule. And so that's something that has just been pushing me, and it's so different than being at school. Online courses are, I had one online class, and it was a math class. That's one online class. And then now I have 6 online classes like everyone else does, and you just have to be a deterrent. You have to have a set schedule. You have to say you're gonna get things done. And I feel like that's the hardest, that's the biggest thing that has affected me, is making sure that I'm getting things done, that I'm getting online. Like, I've missed one assignment already. I've never missed assignments ever. And I missed my first assignment, and I'm like, oh, like, but it was bound to happen. So that's just something that I'll have to learn from. And like I said, I don't know if I said this before, but something that has helped me with transferring online is writing down a set schedule, writing down what you have to get done that day. Because when we were on campus, it's like, oh, you went to class, you had your in-class points. You went to that, you had that. And it's like you had a set schedule. Like, when you're home, you don't really have a set schedule because you have nothing to do. You're just sitting there, and there's really nothing that you have to do except your online work. Except for me filming these videos. And that's something else that I have found really hard to even fit in, is because when I wake up at 9 a.m. and I'm doing homework from 9 till 5 o'clock at night, and then I look up and the day's gone. And that's something that I'm like, these days are going by so fast. That was something else. I'm like, oh my gosh, these days are gonna go by so slow. It's gonna feel like the longest time of my life. No, these past 3.5 weeks have went by so fast. It is insane. It is just, you wake up, you do your work, you go to bed. You wake up, you do your work, you go to bed. And it's the same thing over and over and over again. And I think that is just something that I still haven't got used to. Like I said, I'm a go-go person. I'm going to school to be an elementary teacher. So I don't like the same thing every single day. Like with elementary kids, I'm gonna be doing, you're never gonna have the same day ever. It's always gonna be something different. And so that's something that I'm gonna have to get used to, because I'm like, oh, I'll do this, I'll do that. Because on campus, it's like, oh, we'll meet up a friend at lunch, or you'll do this, you'll do that, you'll do that. And it's like, you have no interaction with anybody except for through your phone or through social media. You only have interaction with people in your house. And that, and something else that I had to get used to is because, oh, I called my mom every day, I did all that, but I was on campus, and we got to go places and sit down and eat lunch. We got to conversate. We got to sit outside on campus and just conversate with people, take a walk around campus town. But here where I live, we're not going anywhere, and no one's going anywhere. And that's something that many people are dealing with. But so, like I said, tomorrow's my birthday. I'll add all this stuff in, and I'll just basically explain how the birthday in quarantine is gonna go. So thanks, see ya.